Matter of fact, I'm going to promote you. You're not even a bitch. You're an asshole. That's a promotion. I'm back with another drunk reaction, and today I'm drinking Tennessee Fire. Oh, yeah. I can think of no better drink than Tennessee Fire for a show like Ozark. And so that's going to be, I'm going to go ahead and demolish a bottle of that today. I'm going to knock out as many Ozarks as I can. I've started to realize I think it's probably better than just doing like one episode of this and one episode of that and one episode of this and one episode of that. It makes me forget things like, you know, I noticed when I started to edit episode one of season two, which from your perspective, you have seen about 10 days ago, I couldn't even remember Rachel's name. That's because I'm jumping around too much. You know, drinking, okay, you know, that has memory issues. Then I was born with memory issues, and now I'm jumping around. I'm watching 18 shows at once, so not a good thing. So I'm going to try to do more of today is Ozark today, tomorrow is Mr. Robot Day, the next day is Orphan Black Day, etc. Yeah, so we'll see how it goes. So anyway, my drink of the day is Tennessee Fire, and my show of today is Ozark. So let's get into it. This is episode 3, Once a Langmore, which means we're going to be dealing with punk-ass Root Dad, whatever the fuck his name is, country-ass, punk-ass, fucking street thug-level bad guy. Like, I mean, I really thought he was going to be like the head of a family-type bad guy we got from Justified, and he's just a fucking street-level thug. So hopefully we can just go ahead and kill this motherfucker this episode. I'm totally down with that.
God damn it, do I need to call security?
If you just make a statement.
Well, I wish I hate anything as much as politicians hate reporters. Salty as fuck, boy.
Do I really need to make this call?
Okay, we're leaving. This is public property and the press is entitled to access.
Holy shit. That I did not see coming. God damn. I did not see that coming. I mean, obviously it staged as a suicide. It's even possible it was a murder. Probably suicide, but you know, I'm suspicious as fuck. We'll just put it that way. I mean, I don't know, man. That was wild.
Our reporter was asking about our bill.
Oh.
She was asking about you.
Yeah, she already called me.
Oh, shit.
What did you say?
Gotcha. This is going to be about her feeling guilty. Okay. The consequences of her actions feeling guilty. Okay, I get it now. It's a suicide. If it was a murder, she'd have to feel guilty about. So it's a suicide. Gotcha.
Oh. Wasn't ready to quite talk about it yet, but...
It's our casino.
Well, dude, you have this big-ass motto in your house. You're ready to talk about it.
See you, pal.
Gotta hate this motherfucker.
I'm sorry. I laid hands on you.
Well, he says that while he's laying hands on her. I know in a different way, but you know what I'm saying.
You wanna talk about a house, all that shit? Well, listen.
She ain't talking about shit.
Is owned at least in part by this number company that we've named El Diablo, based in Mexico City.
Who's the other owner of Paradise?
What an original name.
Revised timeline?
A month to a warrant, two tops.
Agent Evans, do you concur?
2 or 3 months. <seems possible.
laughs> That's right, undercut this son of a bitch.
Hello, anybody here?
Touch squirts always show up here early, it's a fucking thing.
Touch squirts. I am not Googling that.
Hey, are you the owner? Because every piece of paper I have here lists the owners, Rachel Gams.
Yeah. Well, she's, you know,
great, so now he, this is going to make him need Rachel. So gotcha.
You can go back to being silent. I need Mr. Garrison.
Yeah. Well, that's so the FBI is doing this so that he needs Rachel. Gotcha.
Well, I'll give her a call.
Very clever. Create a need and then you solve it. That's classic leverage. You know, I mean the show leverage. So? As well as the word leverage.
And I gotta explain that to Chicago and to the Snells. They're not gonna be happy about that.
I can't get another business.
Where?
I think I might have something.
No, well, appreciate it. Thank you, Ruth. But, you know, we
don't shut her down, you asshole. When look, I get what Marty's saying. You need to focus on your current business. But hear Ruth out, dumbass.
I got a business proposition.
I heard you had money trouble, and I want to invest in your business.
She's becoming a tiny Marty.
You both tell them back. I tell the boys to be sure you pay before they give you the key.
Everybody around here is a dick. Like, Marty went through this in season one, you know? There must be a dick school around here somewhere where everybody learns how to be a dick.
Anyone run to fight that long?
The old man don't give a shit, man.
Not if you keep talking.
I love this old fuck. He's what we call backup. See, and he's got old man strength and dead man strength. Those are two different strengths. So you ain't going, huh, Wendy? Okay.
You know, I don't really believe in this sort of thing.
No harm in trying.
Oh, okay. Gotcha. Darlene's staying behind, so that's why Wendy's staying behind. Gotcha. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we saw Omen 3. We get it.
Where are you going?
Oh, right the fucking thing. I gotta drive Charlotte home.
Wait, no. You're wasted.
Those back rooms.
He's a fucking idiot.
Mr. Wilkes doesn't believe anything is impossible. That's why he's been as successful as he's been.
Can Mr. Wilkes fly to the moon? Like, you know, him personally without a rocket? Well, I guess we're going to have to hang the minion there up by his nuts on the fucking front porch. And then maybe Wilkes' answer will change. It's the FBI doing it, though. Like, they're doing it so that he needs Ruth. Or Rachel. They're doing it so he needs Rachel. Like, Wilkes ain't doing it. They want us to think Wilkes is doing it, but he's not doing it. See, the writers tipped their hand when they said we had to talk to Rachel specifically. That's how I know it's the FBI.
A lot of nerve, Colin.
Apparently, you're the only person that the inspector will deal with. Okay.
Yeah, nothing suspicious about that, right?
Great. Thank you. Prick.
He has the most patronizing thank you I've ever heard in my life.
Hello. Hi. Are you Wendy?
And I've heard librarians.
I'm Janet.
He might as well be trying to solve a quadratic equation. If Twitter was a sentient human being, that would be this motherfucker. And I'm not implying he is sentient, by the way. Fucking dumbass. Maybe she solves this problem, she talks to the widow. I'm telling you, man, like, I hated Wendy early on. She's as ratchet as Marty is. And I like it. She's a go-getter. She gets shit done. She does more in one episode than Skyler did in an entire fucking series.
But he didn't kill your husband.
You work this shit, Wendy. Work this shit.
And I learned very quickly.
Well, she is really poured it on. Using your dead kid. God damn, you're scandalous, boy. Holy shit.
I mean, it might seem that way.
You're using your dead kid as a prop, you fucking bitch. Matter of fact, I'm going to promote you. You're not even a bitch. You're an asshole. That's a promotion. You magnificent bastard. I'm telling you, man, she's on Marty's level. I hope people see that.
Just tell me you don't understand any of the particulars.
See, I knew it was this son of a bitch.
So did Hitler. He held on to his power because no one stood up.
People ain't afraid of
him. Yeah, save it for your blog, crazy bitch. Again, remember how I talked last season? This dude does his own work. He really is. He's a hands-on type person. I don't think that's a good thing. You need to delegate, man. The Mexican cartel stays as powerful as they are because they know how to delegate. They got minions. You don't see the head of the cartel. We don't even know his name. We've never seen his face. Because he ain't worried about this little shit, you know?
No, I've been thinking about...
Something crazy?
I want a baby.
Holy shit. Can you imagine how crazy that fucking baby be? Jacob is running like that fucking Muppet running gif. He's running in his mind right now.
Oh, turn the lights off, man. Come on, the place is shut the fuck down anyway.
You okay?
We'd still need to see, asshole.
Yeah.
That way you won't see my gun under the table.
I'm sorry about that.
That's the...
How's he supposed to read in the dark, you dumb bitch?
You all right? Hey, what's wrong with you?
Oh, it's she mixed the drugs and alcohol. She repeated the "you're late" thing twice, which makes me think that he was late, so she started drinking, which she wasn't supposed to do.
They're gonna lock you up, or they're gonna kill you.
Oh shit. Well, that FBI agent cannot find a good CI to save his fucking life or his job. The fuck you doing, Ruth? She's proven to this dumbass that he needs a breakwater. Whatever the fuck a breakwater is, by the way. His customer's gonna be mad as a motherfucker.
Our conversation from 2 days ago.
Speaking of magnificent bastards, there's a triumvirate of bad motherfuckers on this show, and she is level. She's the third one.
You're worse than your dad.
Yeah, because she's smart, dumbass.
I get it.
What about what she was saying, man? Like, this is just dumb. Marty's smarter than this. Blowing her off is not a good idea, man.
You know, I thought you'd be a real cunt.
Look who's talking. thank you.
Thank you. This is delicious. I shouldn't be saying this. Why?
Keep reading, it gets better.
It would have to.
My childhood traumas are not like yours. My mother's leaving.
Did she not read the whole thing before she came in here to cuss him out? Did she just read the first line? These fucking bobcats, man. She's gonna do something with these bobcats. They're centrally located in the shot, right?
Walking the same fucking path you always walked. Cause nothing's
meanwhile, her loser fucking dad's behind her. We see you, motherfucker.
Losing your shit, baby girl.
Fuck off. Fuck off, I said. I spoke clearly, motherfucker.
Someone wanted to chop others for parts. You probably make a fair amount of coin.
I thought you didn't approve of
this motherfucker shit. Would rather crime than have a real job, you know? Yep, I knew it. She's gonna let him out. Fuck it. Well, that was depressing. I feel like they're still setting the table. Maybe one more episode of table setting, and then we're really gonna start hauling ass. That's the way I see it.